All right, Gianna, thank you so much for making the time to chat with me. I remember the very first time I saw you speak. It was at Sonoma County Women in Conversation, and you were sitting down in front of an audience of women, and you were fully captivating and had everyone's attention speaking to them. So thank you so much for making the time to talk with me. I want to introduce you, Gianna Biaggi. You are the founder of Magnolia Global Academy, and I want to know everything that you can tell me in a very short period of time about what just sparked in you to create this academy. And what is it about?
I grew up here in Sonoma County, and I went to public school. I went to Sonoma Valley High School. I ended up graduating from there. And so I have a really unique lived experience that a lot of people in education in our county, quite frankly, don't, in that I am local and I went to the public schools, and then I went away to school. So spending time away, both, you know, on the East Coast and then abroad and working in different countries, really gave me a unique perspective on kind of what things could be. I think in education, we're really stuck on this idea of like, we've always done it this way, so let's keep doing it this way. But, you know, in the business world, if you are doing the same thing and getting negative results, you would make changes. And we in education really need to adopt that mindset, right? If you're doing the same thing over and over and there's not really a net positive or even a net zero, then you need to make changes. So our goal with Magnolia Global Academy is to give Sonoma County public school students and Petaluma students more specifically, high quality experiential learning programs, project-based learning curriculums, as well as experiences domestically and internationally, where they really get to hone their leadership skills and learn about the world around them. Our eventual goal, right, is that all of our students will graduate from our high school. You know, students will go on to college, they'll go on to trades, they'll go to the junior college, they'll do whatever path they find, but then they will come back to Sonoma County and make our community a more just and equitable place because they've had this really high quality education and are really prepared to take on leadership roles within our community. So this is not just a benefit for these, you know, couple hundred students. It's actually a benefit for our whole community and our whole county, because we'll have people in leadership positions that have been preparing for this since they were in, you know, the seventh or eighth grade.
I love it. So, you know, in just a few sentences, in a couple of moments, you managed to paint such a big picture of what it is that your vision is. And I love that you have a long-term vision. You really are able to see the end result for the community, for these young people who are going to start their own families and go into companies or start their own companies, and how they're going to be shaping their world as a result of participating in your academy. So with that big vision, you must have a really clear definition of what education means to you and what education will mean for everyone who works at the academy and everyone who attends the academy. What is that definition of education?
Well, I know for me personally, I feel like education is a process and something that you choose to engage in every day. And so it's not about having advanced degrees. It's not really about, you know, being in a classroom, but it's about engaging with the larger world around you, engaging with the news, engaging with your community, reaching across lines of difference to understand kind of things that are happening that you might not have a lived experience of. So for me personally, that's my definition of education. I feel like every day I wake up and I choose to be educated that day or not. I can say like I choose to expand my mind, or I can choose to kind of live in a bubble and live in maybe fear or anxiety. But my goal is to really expand my own mind. And I would say that that's really the goal of Magnolia Global Academy, is to give students the opportunity to expand their horizons outside of, you know, what we've traditionally thought of education as, which is you read, you write, you regurgitate. That's really not preparing anyone to do any meaningful work in the 21st century economy. Like, students need to be able to think critically, to solve problems, and to work together. And so our goal is to really give our students the opportunity to experience all angles of education. It's not just taking tests, it's doing community service, it's doing internships, it's working within a team to build out a project. It's like solving math problems with a kindergartner that they're tutoring. It's all these different facets that really make up your education. And then you really, after you've had these experiences, you really get to choose how you use it. and how you go out and take the education that you have and kind of give it to others as well.
I love that. You're really talking about participation and you're talking about access, right? I think the education model that we are used to, that is traditional and has become the status quo, it kind of fits everyone into this one particular lane. It's very siloed. And I think students, individuals get glimpses of what is possible and glimpses of choice even, right? I can choose to learn more about this and I can choose to delve more into this or experience it. But you're really talking about creating a culture at your academy of taking chances and taking risk and leaning into the uncomfortable. And that takes a lot of courage. So tell me a little bit about the values that you are infusing into your team, your staff, educators who are part of the academy, and then the students and their families. What are the values that you want them to have front and center every single day as they're participating and experiencing the academy?
Well, I'm glad you said that, because one of our values is actually what we call positive risk taking, because I think we risk-taking is often associated with something negative, like maybe driving without a seatbelt, but risk-taking can actually be really positive. And anytime you see someone leading or being vulnerable or starting something new, that's actually a really positive risk that they're taking that will ultimately benefit lots of people. So our big core values are experiential learning. And underneath that is positive risk-taking, you know, working with your hands, learning by doing, community citizenship. So making sure that everyone in our community is active, right? Like, how are you an active member of your community? How are you engaging with the community around you? I think too often in Sonoma County public schools, our business community is very separate from our high schools. And, you know, students from the high schools, maybe they work at local businesses or, like, you know, maybe our more privileged students, they do internships, but there's really a big disconnect between what happens in the business community, which is super cool and amazing, and then what happens in the schools. And the schools don't really always feel the effects of the amazing stuff going on in our business and our ag communities. And we really want to bring that together, right? So how do we work in partnership with industry experts? Global citizenship is obviously a core value of ours. So having a mind that is open to new experiences, both internationally and domestically, understanding that you could drive to Arizona and just because you're in the same country does not mean that it's going to be exactly like Sonoma County, right? It's completely different. Your mind will be completely opened in a new way. And then of course, our last big core value is this commitment to equity. So ensuring that every student has what they need to succeed. We're not talking about equality. We're not just going to give everyone the same thing. We've been doing that for years in public education, and quite frankly, it just hasn't worked. We're talking about recognizing that certain populations of students may need different supports, and how do we give that to them to make sure that everybody has the opportunity to pursue whatever they want to pursue post-graduation.
Yeah, again, what comes to mind is education of the public and access, right? So you were talking about something around, you were mentioning business, and you were talking about that overlap of education, particularly in the higher grades, but even like middle school. I remember growing up in Europe, we were required to have practicums from the age from grade 6 onward. So your education became much more tailored to your likes and dislikes, to your aptitudes, to your interests. And so, you know, not everyone. I did a practicum at a bakery, you know, just to kind of like discern whether or not I want to wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning and bake croissants. But it taught me so much about work ethic, about access to that particular field. I learned so much from just being immersed in that environment for 3 weeks. How can business participate better? Business people, companies, how can we participate better with young people and giving them the opportunity to see a little bit behind the scenes of what business is? Because business can be a force for good. And these young people are the next generation of team members and then team leaders and leaders of companies. So how can we participate better?
I think there's a lot of things that businesses can do, and it's not, you don't have to like overhaul your whole model. It's not about, you know, all of a sudden you're going to be losing profit. It's really small things that can actually have a huge impact on students' like life and future choices, as well as on schools. And so I think, you know, what we're trying to do with Magnolia Global Academy is have student interns every year. 11th grade students will go out into the community and do a 4-week internship. And this is across the board. Every student will do this. I know at some schools in Sonoma County, they do have internship programs, but not every student participates. Again, we want every student, regardless of what track you're on. If you're track, you know, if you're 100% going to college, you should still do an internship. And if you're 100% not for you, you should still do an internship. There's value in both groups of students doing it. And so I think businesses play a really vital role in pushing schools to really upgrade and modernize into the 21st century. When I work with business professionals here in Sonoma County, what they often say to me is like, hey, we love to hire your students from the local high schools, but they take a lot of training because they've never had any exposure, right? Mm-hmm. They've never really seen a lot of these fields, or they just don't really know what's out there. So hosting students for field trips, if you have a factory, if you have a farm, if you have a business, if you're doing something really cool that would be really interesting for students, like why are you not bringing them into that class, into that space, and letting them explore for a day, meeting with people on your staff, meeting with COOs, having kids go into a boardroom, you know, having kids sit in on meetings, like learning about kind of how these different things work, you know, mentoring students directly through a local high school. So kind of an internship, maybe where students are learning. You as a business leader is saying like, are you interested in, maybe if you're interested in ag, you know, let's spend time with me. We can talk about this kind of, here's how my career path went. How can I show you how your career path could go? And then of course, working with teachers, because teachers have the most access to students, and they're also the most willing to try new things, right? And our teachers here in Sonoma County are amazing. And so partnering with a teacher to bring resources into their classroom, to bring, you know, students to field trips and other opportunities could be really, really valuable. And it would be a way to reach lots of kids, right? You would be reaching 25 to 50 to even, depending on the class and the teacher, 100 kids if they have like many sections, you'd be able to reach a lot of kids that way. So I think there's a lot that can be done. And I think what we really need is we need educators and business leaders to come to the table and kind of commonly agree that we all want what's best for our students and figure out how do we create some solutions here. Because we really need to tap into the business community in Sonoma County. Like there's just so much that could be done.
I love how passionate you are about Sonoma County and about the students and the community here. I feel very similarly because this is the place I live in and my kids go to school here, and I want people to have opportunities to grow and succeed in Sonoma County. We always talk about how expensive and how inaccessible Sonoma County can be, but there are so many opportunities here, and business owners and educators are both on two different sides of the spectrum, can interact with one another to make this a really viable and flourishing area for people to continue to grow in, and not just to come in and transplant to Sonoma County, but our own students and our own young people to see opportunity here. So I love your passion for this, and I love your passion for our community. I'm thinking about people who are listening to this who are maybe not familiar with Sonoma County, who are in their own communities and are in business and are thinking about what are the needs in their own communities, in their own teams and companies that they are facing, and they're not really sure how to address them. But here you are, you saw a need and you're addressing it. What happened for you to really take that chance, to take that courage, and to take that positive risk, as you put it, and go forward and make a change? What was that for you?
I think I just got to a point in my life where I felt like I had these skills, I had this knowledge, and I had this really local context. And I feel like I talk about, I'm like, Sonoma County so much, but I do think it matters when you have local people kind of running the show. I think there's a level of nuance and context that we understand that just makes it easier to get things done, to be quite frank. And I also knew around the time our school was starting, I have a sister who's in high school, and my parents were trying to find an appropriate option for her, and the options were super limited. And we knew that going in, but like being faced with the choice of like, where does my own sister go to school? It felt like more urgent to me. Like it felt like, okay, kind of the time is now, you should do something about this. And so I feel like, you know, this, I feel like anyone could really do this. I don't feel like it's just like me. I feel like I'm just kind of a vessel for what a lot of people want. And I'm just kind of like, I'm carrying it forward, but it's like lots of people's ideas and dreams and hopes kind of like on my back. But, you know, I really, really hope that, and I know that there are lots of other young people in across the world that are just like me, and they just need like a little bit of a push, kind of like I got, and they could absolutely do this.
So you're really talking to the part where you also got support. I know we had a little bit of a conversation about you are the founder, you are the innovator, the brainchild, the idea person behind this academy and the vision for it and what you want for it. And then you have the people that come alongside you to support you and to give you some fuel and some thrust to your vision. What keeps you going and how do you stay inspired to inspire your team?
Oh, I feel like it's honestly working with people in our community because the amount of support we've had for this school has been staggering. I grew up here and I was very shocked that it was this high. Parents, businesses, students, you know, people who, retirees, people whose children have already graduated from school, but they're still, you know, living here and active in the community. It's really, really crazy how much support we have. Some of the big companies, you know, Miyoko's Creamery, Lagunitas Brewing, Sonoma Creamery, like big companies are really behind us. And I think that's what really inspires me is like realizing like, oh, I'm not just like the only one that wants this, but we have lots of people who are really, really pushing for this as well. And then of course, family. Because families and students, they're the ones who are going to be the most positively impacted by this. So every time I get to talk to a parent, which is like every day, I feel really inspired when they tell me like, you know, this is the place for my child. Maybe their child is having a negative experience in their current school. I have some parents that I talk to who they have preschoolers and they're just like, I can't wait. Like I need this school to come up because I have a kid who's 3. And so it's really, really cool getting to speak with parents because you know that they're going to be the ones who benefit the most from this. So I would say I'm really inspired by people in our community who have really gotten behind this. And then I use that to hopefully inspire everyone else.
I love it. So I'm curious, you know, when you are a visionary and when you have the idea and you're creating this really big dream and this really big vision for everyone to be fueled by, then you're also strategizing and you're creating these tactics and you're implementing all of these various tactics to take action and to take the steps to hopefully move forward. You no doubt are also running into obstacles. What are some of the biggest obstacles did you run into?
I would say one of the biggest obstacles we faced here in our context is a lack of inertia of people just saying to me fairly frequently, we've never done this here, therefore it can't be done. And that's really a fallacy. That's not logical to say just because it's never happened doesn't mean it can't happen. So I think that mindset is really indicative of what's holding a lot of us back. Mm-hmm. And it's, we really need to think about different solutions. If you drive 40 miles south to San Francisco, you will see a school that is just like MGAL. So this is not, it's not like a pipe dream. This is absolutely possible. We just need to be open to different solutions for some of our problems. But I do think, again, looking at the community support, you know, while we do run into some of that mindset, it's a lot less than the amount of support we have. So that makes it all a little bit easier.
You know, you're speaking to the point of you know, when you're introducing something new to a community, this is every leader that is faced with this. We introduce something new to our team, to our company, to our community. And often the fear of something new just gets in the way and we can't, you know, we can't overcome that, or we believe we can't overcome it because it takes a lot of education, a lot of empathy, a lot of compassion, a lot of conversation to move the needle forward. And to your point, you know, you're not trying to reinvent the wheel. And in fact, there are other models very similar to the model that you are launching here in this community. But you are very innovative. You are recognizing a problem in this particular community, for our young people and for our future, and you're innovating a solution and you're introducing a solution that is perfectly new to everybody. So, you know, naturally you will have the objection, as frustrating as it may be, but I admire your grit and I admire your stick-to-itiveness and your leadership. And that's what I saw the very first time I heard you speak. It wasn't just, you know, it wasn't just your passion for the solution. It was also your absolute unquestionable willingness and your track record of rolling up your own sleeves and getting in there and getting it done. And I very much admire that about you. So I want to know who your role models are and have been in your life.
Definitely my mom. I feel like, you know, my mom, she didn't have as many options as I have, but she really made the best of them. And I think that's really, really inspiring to me. And I think a lot of the women who have come before me in innovation, in education, the women who founded women's colleges back when it was really, really hard to do so, those are my role models. And the women I work alongside in our community, Vanessa Luna Shannon, Kenyatta Reynolds, Jennifer Gray Thompson, like, you know, Jean Kearns, these are all women on our board, and they have created such amazing lives for themselves. And they've opened a lot of doors for me to think about what my life could be that I never would have thought was possible. And so I think those women, you know, you, Bianca, just getting to see what other women do every day and realizing that there's so much out there that I maybe didn't know about as a 16, 17 year old, and maybe that I still don't know about as, you know, a young person. That's really inspiring to me.
I love that. And thank you. I think, you know, when you're talking about inspiration, and you are a young woman and you are a vibrant young woman, I think what is really exciting to me as a woman in business and as a woman who's raising women is that this is a conversation that isn't just for women. And I'm really excited to see this conversation fanning out and opening up, and diversity, equity, and inclusion being a real activity in companies, right? So it's not just about the talking about diversity, equity, and inclusion, but really taking action on it. And it is, empowerment is a tricky thing because it's not just a one and done. It's a constant reconfirming and reiterating and literally noticing a need and coming alongside somebody. Early in our conversation, you were talking about your students mentoring a kindergartner, right? So no one is too young or too old to recognize that you have knowledge and experience and ability to support another person. And so that's really what you're describing when you're describing these mentors that you're looking up to and how you're mentoring others. It's a really beautiful full circle kind of a picture you're describing. And I find that very inspiring.
Thank you. I mean, and that's really the goal of the school, right? Is that no one, it's like that Gloria Steinem quote. It's like, we are not ranked as people, we are linked. And if we do not realize that we are linked together as people, then nothing is going to get done. We're going to keep solving this or trying to solve the same problem. So we feel that we are a linked team. We want to be linked with the community to really push this forward. Again, it's not about me. I am just the vessel, I feel like, mm-hmm. for other people's hopes and dreams and ideas. And I'm just the one carrying it forward. But this really is a community project for all of us.
I think leadership is often about holding creating and holding a container, right? There has to be boundaries and form and shape to what it is that you're doing. And as a leader, it's your role to kind of hold that shape and to create that shape and to keep people focused in a direction. But I love how you're describing that, because yes, a vessel has a shape and it's moving into a direction. And you, as the leader of this particular organization, are not just bringing around with you everyone who is in the vessel, but it's also impacting everyone around you. And so I can't wait to see how that's going to unfold over the next years to come. And really, you are having a generational value proposition here, right? It's year over year, generation over generation. So with that sort of concept in mind, I'm so curious, as a mother of a 16-year-old high schooler, I just I just know these years are everything to these kids. They're everything to the parents. I could just cry thinking about her graduating and the choices that she's going to be empowered to make. I want to hear from you. Imagining a young student who comes into the academy and then goes through the academy, graduates, and goes through their life, say the next 10, 15 years of their lives. Paint a picture for me of who you are imagining and what this person, what this individual is capable of and how their life is better because they have been part of the academy that you founded.
I think our biggest goals is that student has a deep level of empathy and they have a deep ability to understand and to build connection across lines of difference, right? Whether it's with someone of a different gender, a different race, from a different country, or someone from a different background, a completely different background, or from a different area. Coming across, like building across lines of difference is really what makes us stronger. That's really going to uphold the fabric of Sonoma County and more broadly our society. And so our graduates, they will be empathetic leaders who can build across lines of difference. That's really what we want. We want people that can come to the table, that can make consensus, and they can then become a vessel for moving things forward in our community, no matter what their profession is, no matter if they are the US Attorney General or if they are, working in a school or if they're working in a cheese factory. They should be able to do that because we know it'll make everyone's lives better.
So tell me a little bit about how we, the community, and also anyone who's listening, how can we participate in supporting you and your vision and your leadership of this vessel moving forward?
I think there are just so many ways, and being able to talk to industry experts like yourself has really helped in terms of building out our strategy, right? Because we're not just building an educational program. We also have to roll out a business plan and a model and strategize, like you said, be tactical. How do we get people on board? So, talking to you has been really helpful in that regard. For the larger business community, working with us to host student interns and externs, committing to assisting with the building of our programs, right? Like what do you know about the industry that we don't know that we can bring together? Assisting us with building relationships with other businesses so students can go and do field trips and internships and things like that. Coming and being part of our foundation board. Like these are all areas where we really want the business community's input because we know that it'll be so beneficial for students. And I also think we can get creative, right? Just because I gave those four suggestions, there are lots of things you as a business owner know that I don't know. And what can we do to figure out where our goals are in alignment and how can we kind of work together in that way?
You know, when you were speaking just then, the term that came to mind is it takes a village, right? It really does take a village. And I grew up in a very different setting, in a very different country. I grew up in communist Romania with very, very much down to earth because we had to be, right? Incredibly impoverished and oppressed. But one of the things that I remember about growing up in my formidable years was it was really everything was such a community effort. The pressure was off to be good at everything. And I think a lot of times, particularly business owners, think they have to be good at everything they do. And that's just such, that's such a false frame of a mind because it really sets you up for failure because there's no way you can know everything. But really having that collaborative approach that you're describing of everyone coming together and offering just really what they have and what they can bring to the table. And being really intentional about the value that and the mission that you set forth. And that's really great leadership on your part. So I again want to just commend you for being so clear and so straightforward and so passionate and willing to take the action, which I think is speaks to your just to your grit as a human being, as a woman, and what you're bringing to the table. We are so fortunate, truly, to know you and to get to learn from you. So I hope everyone calls you and has at least a conversation with you about what it is that you need and how they can actively support you in creating a better education program for Sonoma County and a better option for those kids who want it.
Thank you, Bianca. I really, really appreciate it.
There are so many people who do things that no one knows about that are so much more important than really than we know, or than really hardly anything else could be that important, because you're impacting our community and these in for generations. Truly, I just am so impressed and so want the best for you.
Thank you so much. And thank you for having me. I really appreciate
it. Of course. Thank you. Have a good day. And we'll chat soon.
Thank you.